Hi students, welcome to KSM classes. Today we will discuss the mains paper held on 7th January 2020, shift 2. So that is the paper in the afternoon session. We will discuss the first question. In a workshop, there are 5 machines and the probability of any one of them to be out of service on a day is 1/4. If the probability that at most 2 machines will be out of service on the same day is 3/4 whole cube into k, then k equal to. Let us consider p as the probability form a machine to be out of service is equal to 1/4. Q can be chosen as 1 minus p. Here, whatever it may be, whatever you require, here the required one is the probability that at most 2 machines will be out of service. So out of service itself is taken as a success. Q is the failure of probability for the failure, that is 1 minus 1/4, that is equal to 3/4. N is equal to number of machines. Is equal to 5. X denotes the here at most 2 machines will be out of number of machines that are out of service, or number of machines out of service. So now here we are asked to find out that on a day the probability for at most 2 machines, at most means maximum 2, that is p of x less than or equal to, that is equal to p of x is equal to 0 plus p of x is equal to 1 plus p of x is equal to 2. Here p of x is equal to r can be taken as ncr into p to the power of r into q to the power of n minus r, where n is the number of trials, here in the problem number of machines. So p of x is equal to 0. Here it is given as 3/4 whole cube into k. So it implies that p of x equal to 0. Phi c 0, p to the power of 0, that is 1/4 whole power 0 into 3/4 whole power 5 plus phi c 1 into 1/4 into 3/4 whole power 4 plus phi c 2 into 1/4 whole square into 3/4 whole cube is equal to 3/4 whole cube into k. That implies you can take 3/4 whole cube as common. Then you are left with phi c 0 is 1, 1/4 whole power 0 is 1, 3/4 whole square 9/16 plus phi c 1 is 5, 1/4 into 3/4, because 3/4 whole cube is taken common. Phi c 2 is 10, this is 1/16 is equal to 3/4 whole cube into k. This 3/4 and 3/4 gets cancelled. This is 9, 9 plus 15, 24, 34/16 is equal to k, implies k is equal to 17/8, that is the third option. The second problem is, let alpha and beta be the roots of the equation x squared minus x minus 1 is equal to 0. The roots are alpha comma beta. It is given that pk is equal to alpha power k plus beta power k, k greater than or equal to 1. Now then, which of the following statements is not true? It is given from p1 to p5. Let us find out p1 to p5 first. Here alpha comma beta being the roots, alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a is equal to 1, alpha beta equal to c by a is equal to minus 1. Now p1 is equal to alpha plus beta, that is 1. P2 is equal to alpha square plus beta square equal to alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta. Alpha plus beta whole square. Alpha plus beta 1 minus 2 alpha beta. 2 into alpha beta is minus 1. So this is plus 2. This is 3. Next P3. P3 alpha cube plus beta cube. Alpha plus beta whole cube minus 3 alpha beta into alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta whole cube 1 minus 3 into alpha beta is minus 1. So 3 alpha plus beta. So 3, this is 4. Now P4. P4 is alpha power 4 plus beta power 4. Alpha square plus beta square whole square minus 2 alpha square beta square. Alpha square plus beta square is P2. P2 is 3. So 9 minus alpha beta is minus 1. It's square. 1 minus 2. This is 7. P5. Alpha power 5 plus beta power 5. This is alpha cube plus beta cube into alpha square plus beta square. Alpha power 5 minus alpha cube beta square minus alpha square beta cube. If you take minus common, it will become plus. So this is alpha cube plus beta cube is 4. Alpha square plus beta square is 3. Minus, this is here alpha square beta square common into alpha plus beta. This is a 12 minus alpha beta is minus 1. It's a square. 1. This is also 1. So this is 11. Among the options, one of the options is P5. P5 equal 11 is correct. Next, P3 equal to P5 minus P4. P5, 11 minus P4, 7. P5 minus P4. So, one of the options given is P5 equal to 11. This is correct. Second option is, one of the other option is P5, P3 is equal to, P3 means 4. P5 minus P4, that is 11 minus 7, that is 4, that is also correct. One more option is P1 plus P2 plus P3 plus P4 plus P5. P1 plus P2 plus P3 plus P4 plus P5. So the sum 1 plus 3, 4, 8, 15, 26. This is also correct. The one more option is P5 is equal to P2 into P3. P5 is equal to, P5 is 11. P2 into P3. P2 into P3 means P2 is 3, P3 is 4. So this is wrong. It is asking the problem that which of the statements is not true. So the first option, P5 equal to P2 into P3 is the answer. The third problem. The locus of the midpoint of the perpendicular is drawn from points on the line x is equal to 2y to the line x is equal to y is. Let us consider it. Let us have the coordinate plane. Let this be the line x is equal to 2y. And let this be a line x is equal to y. From a point on the line x is equal to 2y, a perpendicular is drawn to the line, this one. You can take this point as P and you can take this as Q. Now, the locus of the midpoint of the perpendicular is drawn from this point. So, this is M. You can call this as H, K. Now, you have to find the locus of this point, H, K. Let this point be alpha, comma, alpha. Now, here, the slope of this line is 1. So, the slope of this line is minus 1. The slope of this line is minus 1 means here, slope of slope of MQ is equal to K minus alpha by H minus alpha is equal to minus 1. Implies K minus alpha is equal to minus H plus alpha. Alpha is equal to H plus K by 2. Alpha is equal to H plus K by 2. This being the midpoint, this point can be obtained by taking 2m minus q, that is 2h minus alpha and 2k minus alpha. This point is on the line x equal to y. Here, since P is on x is equal to 2y, then 2h minus alpha is equal to 2y, 4k minus 2 alpha. Therefore, this is alpha is equal to, so alpha equal to 4k minus 2h. 4k minus 2h. Now, here alpha is h plus k by 2. It implies h plus k by 2 is equal to 4k minus 2h. H plus k by 2 is equal to, h plus k is equal to 8k minus 4h. Implies 5h is equal to 7k. Locus of M. Locus of M is equal to 5x is equal to 7y, or 5x minus 7y is equal to 0. So it is the third option. The fourth, next problem. If 3 plus I sin theta by 4 minus I cos theta, comma theta belongs to pi by 2, comma pi closed is a real number, then the argument of sin theta plus I cos theta is, it is given that 3 plus I sin theta by 4 minus I cos theta, theta belongs to pi by 2 comma pi, is a real number, is a real number. Now, let us simplify this one. 3 plus I sin theta by 4 minus I cos theta, let us multiply the numerator and denominator with its conjugate. 4 plus I cos theta by 4 plus I cos theta. And now, this is a 12. This is, we'll take the real part. I square sin theta cos theta minus sin theta cos theta, because I square is minus 1, by this is 16 plus cos square theta plus I into imaginary part. 3 cos theta plus 4 sin theta by 16 plus cos square theta. Given that this z is a real number, is a real number, is a real number, implies imaginary part of z is equal to 0, implies 3 cos theta plus 4 sin theta is equal to 0, implies this is tan theta is equal to, if you take it to the side, minus 4 sin theta. So tan theta equal to minus 3 by 4. Now we are asked to find out the augment of sin theta plus I cos theta. Now another complex number z1 is given, sin theta plus I cos theta. Argument of z1. Argument of z1 is equal to, here since theta belongs to pi by 2 comma pi, that is in the second quadrant, therefore argument must be taken as pi minus tan inverse modulus of cos theta by sin theta. So this is equal to pi minus tan inverse This is cot theta, so modulus of minus 4 by 3. This must be taken, this can be taken as pi minus tan inverse 4 by 3 is the answer. The third option is the answer. The next question. If theta 1 and theta 2 be respectively the smallest and largest values of theta in open 0 comma 2 pi minus minus singleton pi, which satisfy the equation 2 cot square theta minus 5 by sine theta plus 4 equal to 0. Here theta belongs to 0 comma 2 pi minus singleton pi. Now the theta 1 and theta 2 are the smallest and the largest values of theta. From this equation we can write 2 cos square theta by sine square theta minus 5 by sine theta plus 4 equal to 0. We can write 2 minus 2 sine square theta minus 5 sine theta plus 4 sine square theta is equal to 0. Here 4 sine square theta minus 2 sine square theta. 2 sine square theta minus 5 sine theta plus 2 is equal to 0. You can write 2 sine theta minus 1 into sine theta minus 2 is equal to 0 by factorizing. You can check the by multiplying, you can verify also. Sine theta is equal to half or sine theta is equal to 2. This is impossible because since minus 1 less than or equal to sine theta less than or equal to 1 for any theta. Now sine theta equal to half. Between 0 and 2 pi there exists only two values. One is pi by 6 and the other one is in the second quadrant pi by 6. So we can choose theta 1 as the pi by 6, theta 2 as 5 pi by 6. Now we are asked to find out an integral I integral theta 1 to theta 2 cos square 3 theta d theta. Cos square 3 theta d theta. You can write theta 1 is the smallest value, pi by 6, and this is 5 pi by 6, and this is 1 plus cos 6 theta by 2 d theta. And this can be written as 1 by 2 theta between pi by 6 and 5 pi by 6 plus, and this is sine 6 theta by 12 between pi by 6 and 5 pi by 6. And this is half into 5 pi by 6 minus pi by 6 plus, this is 1 by 12 into sine 5 pi by 6, sine 5 pi minus sine pi. And this is equal to 5 pi minus 5, 4, 5 pi minus 5, pi, 4 pi, 4 pi, 2 pi by 4 pi by 12. And this is of course 0. This is 2 pi by, sorry, this is pi by 3. So the option is 4th one. The next problem is the area of the region x, set of all x comma y belongs to R square such that 4x square less than or equal to y less than or equal to 8x plus 12. This is given. First of all, let us have the diagram. We'll consider the two curves as y is equal to 4x square is one curve, y is equal to 8x plus 12 is one curve. Now let us consider the diagram y equal to 4x square. It is a parabola whose axis symmetric about the y axis. So like this. And this is y equal to 8x plus 12. If you put y equal to 0, x is equal to minus 3 by 2 somewhere here. If you put x is equal to 0, y equal to 12 somewhere here. So the line will be like this. So it is intersecting the curve at two points. Now, here we are asked to find out the area of the region 4x square less than or equal to y less than or equal to 8x plus 12. That I mean to say, here between the curve and the line and the curve below the line, y less than or equal to 8x plus 12. This is the region like this. So you can take it like this, this point and this. This is the area required. This is the required area. So this and this one. Now we need the points P and Q. They are nothing but the points of intersection of these two curves. Solving these two curves, we have 4x square is equal to 8x plus 12 implies x square minus 2x minus 3 is equal to 0 implies x minus 3 into x plus 1 equal to 0. Now this is x is equal to minus 1 or x is equal to 3. X is equal to minus 1 implies y equal to 4. X is equal to 3 implies y equal to 36. And therefore, here you can take the point P as 3 comma 36. So this line is x is equal to 3 line. This line is x is equal to 3. So this is 3 comma 0. And this line is x is equal to minus 1. So this point is minus 1 comma 4. So this is minus 1 comma 0. Now the required area of the region or the required area of the region is equal to integral minus 1 to 3. This is the line and this is the curve. So it is the area between the line and the curve. So 8x plus 12 minus 4x square dx. So this is 8 into x square by 2, 4x square plus 12x minus 4x cube by 3 between minus 1 and 3. This is 9 into 4, 36. This is 12 into 3, 36 minus, this is 27 by 3, 9 into 4, 36 minus, this is 4 minus 12 minus 1, so plus 4 by 3. So the resultant is here, you can cancel 36, so 36 and this is minus 8, minus 24 plus 4, minus 20 by 3, plus 20 by 3, 3 into 36, 108, 128 by 3 is the answer. So the third option. The next question is, the number of ordered pairs R, K for which 6 into 35 CR is equal to K square minus 3 into 36 C R plus 1. In this problem, here we can make use of certain formula. NCR is equal to factorial N by factorial N minus R into factorial R. Here N is a positive integer, comma R is an integer such that 0 less than or equal to R less than or equal to N. And the third one, you can make use of factorial N equal to N into factorial N minus 1. These three formulae can be made use here. Now here, this is 6 into factorial 35 by factorial 35 minus R into factorial R. This is K square minus 3 into factorial 36 by 36 minus r plus 1, 35 minus r factorial into factorial r plus 1. Here 35 minus r gets cancelled. R plus 1 factorial by this formula can be written as r plus 1 into factorial r. Factorial r gets cancelled, you are left with r plus 1. 36 factorial can be written as 36 into factorial 35. This 6 can be cancelled as 6. So k square minus 3 is equal to r plus 1 by 6. K square is equal to r plus 1 by 6 plus 1, r plus 19 by 6. It is given that k is an integer. So for k to be an integer, r is equal to 5 implies k square equal to 5 plus 19 by 6 is implies k equal to plus r minus 2, and r is equal to 35. If you take r equal to 35, 54 by 6 is 9. So k is equal to plus r minus 3. Ordered base is equal to 5. Ordered base r comma k is equal to 5 comma minus 2 and 35 comma 3 and 35 comma minus 3. So the number of ordered base is 4. The answer is 3. Next question. The coefficient of x power 7 in the expansion of 1 plus x whole power 10 plus x into 1 plus x whole power 9 plus x square into 1 plus x whole power 8 plus 1 plus x power 10. Now here you can take 1 plus x whole power 10 as common. You can write it as 1 plus x. 1 plus x whole power 10 is taken common. Here 1 plus x whole power 9 is there. So 1 by 1 plus x. Plus here x square by 1 plus x whole power 2. That is x by 1 plus x whole square. Plus so on plus x by 1 plus x whole power 10. So this is a GP with first term is a GP with A is equal to 1, R is equal to x by 1 plus x, where n is equal to 11. There are 11 terms. So this is a 1 plus x whole power 10. Here Sn is equal to A into 1 minus r power n by 1 minus r. We will apply this. A into 1 into 1 minus r x by 1 plus x whole power n whole power 11 by 1 minus x by 1 plus x. And this is equal to 1 plus x whole power 10, 1 plus x whole power 10 into, this is 1 plus x whole power 11 minus x power 11 by 1 plus x whole power 11 into, this is 1 plus x minus x, 1 plus x minus x, so 1 by 1 plus x. You can cancel 1 plus x and 1 plus x, and you are left with 10. This 1 plus x whole power 10 is cancelled. So 1 plus x whole power 11 minus x power 11. We are asked to find out the coefficient of x power 7. Coefficient of x power 7 is equal to, in this expansion it is 11c7. Here there is no such a chance. This is same as 11c4. 11 into 10 into 9 into 8 by factorial 4 is 24. 24, 3, 72, 330 is the result.
So the second option is the answer.
The next question is, let the tangent drawn to the circle x square plus y square minus 8x, x square plus y square minus 8x minus 4y plus 16 equal to 0. From 0 comma 0 touch it at the points A and B, then AB square is. Let us have this circle. Now, origin is outside the circle like this. This is the origin. Two tangents are drawn which are meeting at the points A and B. This AB is called the chord of contact of origin. If we draw a perpendicular from origin to the chord of contact, it meets at the midpoint. Now here, this is the length of the tangent. So OA is equal to length of the tangent is equal to root S11. Root S11 is root 16 is equal to 4. This is 4. Now, equation of AB, that is the chord of contact, S1 is equal to 0 implies minus S1 means xx1 plus yy1 plus g into minus 4 into x plus x1 minus 2 into y plus y1 plus 16 is equal to 0. This is 2x plus y minus 8 equal to 0. OM is equal to perpendicular distance from 0, 0 to the chord of contact. 2, you can call this the first equation, 2, 1. And that is equal to C by modulus of C by root of A square plus B square, that is root 5. So this is equal to 8 by root 5. So this is 8 by root 5. This is a perpendicular. And therefore, AM is equal to, or AM square, from triangle OAM, AM square equal to OA square minus OM square in triangle OAM. So this is equal to OA square is 16 minus OM square is 64 by 5. 80 minus 16 by 5. So AM is equal to 4 by root 5. Now AB is equal to 2AM. AB is equal to 2AM is equal to 8 by root 5. A implies AB square equal to 64 by 5. That is the fourth option. Let y is equal to yx be a function of x satisfying y into root of 1 minus x square is equal to k minus x into root of 1 minus y square, where k is a constant, and y of half is equal to minus 1 by 4, then dy by dx at x equal to half. Let us see. Dy by dx means differentiating with respect to x on both sides. So y into derivative of root of 1 minus x square minus 2x by 2 into root of 1 minus x square plus root of 1 minus x square into y1 is equal to derivative of k is 0 minus x into this, the derivative of this uv. So derivative of this is root of 1 minus y square into derivative of x, 1 minus x into derivative of root of 1 minus y square minus 2y by 2 into root of 1 minus y square into y1. Now this is, this 2 can be cancelled, minus xy by root of 1 minus x square plus root of 1 minus x square into y1 is equal to, this is minus root of 1 minus y square minus into minus. So this is a minus into minus plus this 2 into cancel xy by root of 1 minus y square into y1. Now we are asked to find out the y1 at x is equal to half. So at x is equal to half, y is equal to, at x is equal to half, y is equal to minus 1 by 4 is given. So let us substitute these values. So minus 1 by 2 into minus 1 by 4 by, this is square root of 1 minus 1 by 4 plus square root of 1 minus 1 by 4 into y1 minus square root of 1 minus y square. Y is minus 1 by 4. Y square is 1 by 16 plus x is 1 by 2 into minus 1 by 4 by square root of 1 minus 1 by 16 into y1. Let us simplify. This is minus 1 by 2 into minus 1 by 4, 1 by 8. And this is 1 minus 1 by 4, 3 by 4, root 3 by 2, 2 by root 3. Plus, this is 3 by 4, root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2 into y1 is equal to, this is 16 minus 1, 15. Minus root 15 by 4 minus 1 by 8. This is root 15 by 4 means 4 by root 15 into y1. Now you can do one thing. Here, this is root 3 by 2 plus, this is 2 plus 1 by 2 root 15 into y1 is equal to minus root 15 by 4 plus, this is 4. So this is 1 by 4 root 3, and therefore this is equal to, this is 2 root 15 is the LCM, and therefore this is root 45 plus 1 into y1 is equal to minus, the LCM is 4 root 3, and here it is root 15. So 4 root 15 means here 4 is there, root 3, root 45 and plus 1. Root 45 plus 1 gets cancelled. This root 3 gets cancelled, you are left with root 5, and this 2 gets cancelled, you are left with 2. Implies y1, that is equal to dy by dx at x is equal to half is equal to minus root 5 by 2 is the answer. So that is the second option. Next problem. The value of c in the Lagrange's mean value theorem for the function fx is equal to x cube minus 4x square plus 8x plus 11 when x belongs to 0, 1 is. And find the c in the Lagrange's mean value theorem. The Lagrange's mean value theorem says, Lagrange's mean value theorem says, a function f, a function fx is continuous on closed a comma b, differentiable on open a comma b, then there exists at least one c belongs to a comma b such that f dash c equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus a. This is the Lagrange's mean value. We will apply the Lagrange's mean value theorem here. So here in the interval 0, 1, it is said that we are asked to find, it is asked to find out the C in the Lagrange's mean value theorem. So it being a polynomial, it is continuous and differentiable everywhere. Therefore, it is continuous in closed 0, 1 and also differentiable in open 0, 1. By definition, there exists some C such that f dash C equal to, so by Lagrange's mean value theorem, f dash C equal to f of B minus f of A by B minus A, comma C belongs to 0, 1, B is equal to 1 and A equal to 0, implies f dash C, differentiating fx with respect to x and substitute c in place of x. So 3x square, that is 3c square minus 8c plus 8, derivative of limit is 0, is equal to f of B, that is f of 1 minus f of 0 by 1 minus 0. F of 1 is 1 minus 4 minus 3 minus 3 plus 8, 5 plus 11, 16 minus f of 0 is 11, this is 5. So 3c square minus 8c plus, this is 5, this is 3 equal to 0, implies c equal to minus b plus r minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a, that is equal to 4 plus r minus 64 minus 36, 28, 4 into 7, 2 root 7, 2 cancel root 7 by 3, implies c is equal to 4 minus root 7 by 3 belongs to 0, 1, and 4 plus root 7 by 3 does not belong to 0, 1, and by the definition we said that C must be in 0, 1, so C equal 4 minus root 7 by 3, that is the fourth option. The next problem. The sum of the 40 terms of the series, 3 plus 4 plus 8 plus 9 plus 13 plus 14 plus 18 plus 19 plus so on. Here 3, 4, the difference is 1. 4, 8, the difference is 4. So the difference is not same. Here you can do in two different ways. You can add these two, 7, 8 plus 10, 17, 13 plus 14, 27. So 7, 17, 27, 37 like. So the difference is 10. Otherwise also, you can do in one more fashion. First term 3, next 8, next 13, 1, 3, 5 like that. 18 plus 1. This contains 20 terms and the rest of the 20 terms are 4 plus 9 plus 14 plus 19 plus 1. These are 20 terms. Here, the sum of these 20 terms, Sn, so S20, so n by 2 into 2a, 2a means 6 plus n minus 1, n minus 1 means 19 into d, d is 5, plus here 20 by 2 into here 2a, 8 plus n minus 1, 19 into 5. So you can write here sum of n terms of an AP, sum of n terms of an AP is equal to Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. A is equal to first term d, common difference n, number of terms it is already, it is mentioned that sum of n terms. So it is not this, d common first. This is the sum of n terms of any applying here. So this is 10, this is 95 plus 6, 101. 10 into 101 plus, this is 10 into 103. So this is a 10 into 204. So the resultant is 2040 is the answer. And here it is given that the sum of n, 40 terms of the series is 102m, then m equal to. So given that this s is equal to 102m and this is equal to 25, so implies m equal to 102 means 20, so 220, m equal to 20 is the answer, the second option. The next problem is the value of alpha for which 4 alpha into integral minus 1 to 2 e to the power of minus alpha into mod x dx is equal to 5. Here mod x is equal to x if x greater than or equal to 0, minus x if minus x if x less than 0. Here we'll split, because the limits are from minus 1 to 2, there are some negative values and some positive values. We'll split it into several integrals. Integral a to b fx dx can be written as integral a to c1 fx dx plus integral c1 to c2 fx dx plus so on plus integral cn minus 1 to cn fx dx plus integral cn to b fx dx. So these are the two formulas which we can make use of. Here it can be written as 4 alpha into integral minus 1 to 0 e to the power of minus alpha between minus 1 and 0, that is x is taking the negative values, then it is mod x is minus x dx plus integral 0 to 2 e to the power of minus alpha into mod x is x dx is equal to 5. It can be taken as 4 alpha into, this is e to the power of alpha x. So alpha x by alpha between minus 1 and 0 plus, this is e to the power of minus alpha x by minus alpha between 0 and 2 is equal to 5. I mean 4 alpha into e power 0, 1 by alpha minus, this is e power minus alpha by alpha minus, this is e power, if you take minus here, minus e power minus 2 alpha by alpha, if you put minus, this is 1 by alpha is equal to 5. This alpha gets cancelled everywhere. So 4 into, this is a plus 1, so 2 minus e power minus alpha, so that is 1 by e power alpha, and minus 1 by e power 2 alpha is equal to 5. So this is 8 minus 5, 3 minus 4 by e power alpha minus 4 by e power 2 alpha is equal to 0. This can be written as 3 e power 2 alpha, 3 e power 2 alpha minus 4 e power alpha minus 4 is equal to 0. So this is 3 into 4, 12. So 6 into 2. So 3 e power alpha minus 2 into e power alpha minus 2. 3 e power 2 alpha minus 6 e power 2 alpha plus 2 e power alpha minus 4 is equal to 0. So here e power alpha is equal to 2 or e power alpha equal to minus 2 by 3. E power alpha can never be negative. So it is impossible. It never be negative. The exponential function never be negative. So alpha is equal to log 2 base e. This is the fourth option. The next problem. Let a is equal to aij, comma b is equal to bij, b2 3 by 3 real matrices such that bij is equal to 3 to the power of i plus j minus 2 into aji into aji, comma I equal to 1 2 3 and j equal to 1 2 3. If the determinant of b is 81, then the determinant of a is, determinant of b is equal to 81 and we are asked to find out determinant of a. Now here a is equal to, for example, if you take a, this will be that a is equal to of the model a11 a12 a13 b a21 a12 b a13 b21 a22 a23 a31 a32 and a33. Now we select b. Actually b is, that b is like this, b11 b12 b13, like that. But here b11 means you can write it here. For example, b11 means I is equal to 1 and j equal to 1, that is 1 plus 1 minus 2 into aji. So here b11 is 3 to the power of I 1 plus 1 minus 2, 3 power 0 into aji. Aji means a11. Next, b12 means 1 plus 2 minus 2, 3, and this is ij, this is 1 2, this is 2 1, a21. And next 3 square, because this is a a13, 1 plus 3 minus 2, so 3 square, this is 1 3, means this is 3 1, a31. And next this is b21 means 2 plus 1 minus 2, so 3, and this is 2 1, means that is 1 2, so that is a12. And next this is b22 means 3 square, this is 2 2, means a22, and this is b23 means here 2 plus 3 minus 2, 3 cube into this is 2 3, so this is 3 2, a32. And now this is b31 means 3 plus 1 4 minus 2 to 3 square, and this is 3 1, means that is a 3 1, that is 1 3, a13. And next 3 cube, because this is b23, 2 plus 3 minus 2, 3 cube, and this is 2 3, means this is 3 2, 3 cube into a32. And next this is 3 3, 3 plus 3 6 minus 2, 3 power 4 into a33. And now you can take some elements as common. Here in the second row you can take 3 common, and in the third row you can take 3 square common. So this can be written as a11 and a3 a21 and the 3 square a31, and this is 3a12. So this is the taking 3 common, this is a12, and this is 3a22, and this is 3 square a32, and she are taking 3 square common, and this is a13, and this is a3a32, and this is 3 square A33. And now, this is mark that B is given as 81. So 81 is equal to, this is 3 cube, 27, and you can take 3 common from the second column, that is 3, and 3 square common from the third column, 3 square, and now this is A11 and A21, A31 and A12 and A22 and A32, A13, A32, A33. Now this is equal to here 27 into 3 means 81. Here det A is equal to det A transpose. So it's a transpose is det A. So this is equal to 1 by 9. So det A is equal to 1 by 9. So this is the answer. Det A equal to 1 by 9 is the first option. The next problem is, let A comma B comma C and D be four non-empty sets. The contrapositive statement of if A subset B and B subset D, then A subset C. This is the statement given. We are asked to find out the contrapositive. P implies Q is a statement, then it's a contrapositive statement is negation Q implies negation P. This is the contrapositive. Here, if we suppose P as a statement A subset B and Q B subset D and R A subset C, then it is given that if A subset B and P, B subset D, then that is P and Q and Q, then if then implies R. So this is the statement given. So this is the statement, it's a contrapositive is negation R implies negation P R negation Q. Negation P R negation Q. That implies A, now if A not a subset of C, then A is not a subset of B or B not a subset of D. So this is the fourth option. Next problem. If 3x plus 4y equal to 12 root 2 is a tangent to the ellipse x square by a square plus y square by 9 is equal to 1 for some a belongs to R, then the distance between the foci of the ellipse is. Here the tangent is 3x plus 4y equal to 12 root 2. It implies y is equal to minus 3 by 4 into x plus 3 root 2. If y is equal to mx plus c is a tangent to the ellipse, then ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1, then c square equal to a square m square plus b square. This is one formula. Let us make use of here. C square, this is c square means 18 is equal to a square into m square, 9 by 16 plus b square is 9. So this is a square, this is a 9 a square by 16 is equal to 9 implies a square equal to 16. Now b square is already known, that is 9 of course. The eccentricity of the ellipse, eccentricity of the ellipse is equal to E is equal to square root of A square minus B square by A square whenever A is greater than B. Now, so here E is equal to square root of 16 minus 9 by 16 is equal to root 7 by 4. Distance between the 4C is equal to 2A. So 2A, distance between the 4C is equal to distance between 4C is equal to 2A is equal to 2 into A is 4. E is root 7 by 4 equal to 2 root 7. That is, the second one is the option. The next problem. Let A1, A2, so on. A1, A2, A3, so on. Are in GP. Such that A1 less than 0. Given that A1 plus A2 is equal to 4 and A3 plus A4 is equal to 16. We are asked to find out sigma I equal to 1 to 9 AI is equal to 4 lambda, then lambda equal to. Now here we will consider A2 as A1R. So A1R is equal to 4. Implies A1 into 1 plus R is equal to 4. This is A3 is A1R square. A1R square plus A1R cube is equal to 16. You can write A1R square into 1 plus R is equal to 16. So divide these two. R square is equal to 4. R is equal to plus R minus 2. Substitute in this. If R is equal to 2, then A1 is equal to 4 by 3. If R is equal to minus 2, then A1 is equal to R is equal to minus 2. Minus 2 means minus A1. A1 equal to minus 4. But because it is given that A1 is less than 0, this must be considered. A1 equal to minus 4. So here, AI, sigma AI, this is A1 plus A2 plus so on plus A9 is equal to 4 lambda. So A1 is this formula for the sum of the n terms. A into r to the power of n minus 1 by r minus 1. So Sn is equal to A into r power n minus 1 by r minus 1. That is the sum of n terms. So here, this is A1 is minus 4 into r minus 2 to the power of 9 terms. 9 minus 1 by minus 2 minus 1 is equal to 4 lambda. So 4 gets cancelled. This is a 3 minus 3, so cancel. So minus 2 to the power of 9. So minus 512 minus 1 minus 513 is equal to minus 3 lambda. So here lambda is equal to this is minus, this is one more minus, this is a plus. So minus to minus 512, minus 513, so this is 513, and therefore lambda equal to minus 171. The resultant is the fourth option. The next problem is A bar, B bar, C bar with 3 unit vectors. Mod A bar equal to mod B bar equal to mod C bar equal to 1. Such that A bar plus B bar plus C bar is equal to 0 bar. If lambda is equal to A bar dot B bar plus B bar dot C bar, plus C bar dot A bar, and D bar is equal to A bar cross B bar plus B bar cross C bar plus C bar cross A bar, then the ordered pair lambda comma D bar is equal to. Now here A bar plus B bar plus C bar equals 0 bar. So implies mod A bar plus B bar plus C bar whole square is equal to 0. You can apply the general algebra formulas in case of the dot product. When you take the modulus whole square, it is nothing but A bar plus B bar plus C bar dot A bar plus B bar plus C bar. You can write mod A bar square plus mod B bar square plus mod C bar square plus 2 into A bar dot B bar plus B bar dot C bar plus C bar dot A bar is equal to 0. That I mean to say this is 3. So A bar dot B bar plus B bar dot C bar plus C bar dot A bar, this is 3 minus 3 by 2, which is equal to lambda. We are given D bar equal to A bar plus B bar plus B bar plus C bar plus C bar plus C bar. The answers will be in terms of A bar, C bar, C bar, B bar, A bar, B bar. So we will eliminate one of it. D bar is equal to, we'll consider A bar cross B bar plus B bar cross, we'll eliminate C bar through this. C bar equal to minus A bar cross minus B bar plus C bar minus A bar cross minus B bar cross A bar. This is equal to A bar cross B bar minus B bar cross A bar minus B bar cross B bar minus A bar cross A bar minus B bar cross A bar. A bar cross A bar is equal to 0 bar for any A bar. For any A bar. And the second one is, A bar cross B bar is equal to minus B bar cross A bar is equal to B bar cross minus A bar is equal to minus of B bar cross A bar. All these are equal. So this is the, these are the two formulas which will make use of here, and therefore this is A bar cross B bar, and this is A bar cross B bar. This is 0 bar, this is 0 bar, this is A bar cross B bar. So 3 into A bar cross B bar. So lambda comma D bar ordered pair is equal to minus 3 by 2 comma 3 A bar cross B bar. Let us check whether it is in the options or not. It is in the fourth option. If not, we'll, if it is given in terms of B bar and C bar, then we'll eliminate A bar at all. So it being in the options, it is the fourth one is the answer. Next problem. Let y equal to yx be the solution of a curve of the differential equation y square minus x into dy by dx is equal to 1. Satisfying y of 0 is equal to 1, this curve intersects the x-axis at a point whose axis size. Now we'll consider this differential equation as dx by dy is equal to y square minus x. we can write it as dx by dy plus x is equal to y square. It's a linear differential equation. The integrating factor is e to the power of integral dy, that is e to the power of y. Now the solution for the differential equation is x into the integrating factor, x e power y into y square into e to the power of y dy. This implies x into e to the power of y. Here we will apply the integration by parts. We will treat this as the first function and this as the second. So y square into e to the power of y minus integral 2y into e to the power of y dy. Now this can be written as x into e to the power of y is equal to y square e to the power of y. Again, this is 2 into y into e to the power of y minus integral e to the power of y dy. And this is equal to y square e to the power of y minus 2y e to the power of y plus 2 e to the power of y plus c. It is given that y of 0 equal to 1. That is, at x equal to 0, y equal to 1. Put x is equal to 0, comma y equal to 1. This is 0. This is y equal to 1. 1 means e, y equal to 1. So minus 2e, this is plus 2e, plus c. So implies c equal to minus e. Therefore, the solution is x e power y is equal to e power y into e power y into y square minus 2y plus 2 plus c. So minus e into e power minus y. Now the curve intersects the x-axis. So put y equal to 0. Put y equal to 0. E power 0 is 1. X is equal. E power 0 is 1. This is 0. 0. This is 2 minus e power minus y. E power 0 is 1 minus e. So the axis of the point where the curve cuts the x-axis is 2 minus e. So that is the first option. The next problem. Let fx be a polynomial of degree 5 such that x equal to plus or minus 1 are its critical points. If limit extends to 0, 2 plus fx by x cube is equal to 4, then which of the following is not true? Okay. Now here, if you apply the limit, limit extends to 0, this is a constant, it can be pulled out. Fx by x cube is equal to 2. Now it is given that fx is a fifth degree polynomial. Fifth degree polynomial means ax to the power of 5 plus bx power 4 plus cx cube plus dx square plus ex plus f. If you take the constant f by x cube, that will become infinity. But here it is considered, if it is considered ax power 5, bx power 4, cx cube plus dx square plus ex plus f. By x cube means here it is ax square plus bx plus c plus d by x. D by x means as extends to 0, it will become infinity. It also will become infinity. But the resultant is given as a constant term 2. Therefore, our fx must be, according to the concept, fx must be of the form ax cube plus bx square plus, ax power 5 plus bx power 4 plus cx cube. Now, here, limit extends to 0, fx by x cube, ax power 5 plus bx power 4 plus cx cube by x cube is equal to 2. And therefore this is, here if you divide with x cube, ax is 0, bx 0, this is c. So c is equal to 2 is the first option. Therefore our fx is, ax power 5 plus bx power 4 plus 2x cube. This is fx. Now f dash x. F dash x means 5ax to the power of 4 plus 4bx cube plus 6x square. Now here it is given that x is equal to plus or minus 1 are the critical points. Critical point means if a point is said to be a critical point, for example, if x is equal to a is said to be a critical point, f dash a must be equal to 0 or f dash a does not exist. It being a polynomial, it will exist. So f dash 1 is equal to 5a plus 4b plus 6 is equal to 0, f dash minus 1. 5a minus 4b plus 6 is equal to 0. Now here solving these two, subtract b is equal to 0. If you put b equal to 0, a equal to minus 6 by 5. So your fx is minus 6 by 5 x to the power of 5 plus b is 0 plus 2x cube. Among the options it is given that f is an odd function. So f of minus x is equal to minus 6 by 5 into minus x whole power 5 means minus. So 6 by 5 x power 5 minus 2x cube. If you take minus down, this will become minus fx. So f is an odd function. That is correct. Now next, among the options, f of 1 minus 4 f of minus 1. F of 1 minus 4 into f of minus 1. F of 1 means minus 6 by 5 plus 2 minus 4 into f of minus 1. This is minus 1. 6 by 5 and this is minus 2. F of minus 1, minus 2. So this is minus 6 by 5 minus 24 minus 30 by 5 minus 6. 2, this is plus 8. So 10 and that is equal to 4. So this is also correct. But we need the wrong statement. Now we will find out the maximum and minimum points. F dash, f double dash x. F double dash x here, f of x is this. F dash x is 5a x to the 4 n. Now we will go for f dash x with the help of this f dash x. So this is x power 5. So minus 5x power 4 minus 6x power 4 and this is 6x square. 6x square. Already it is noted that 1 and minus 1 are the critical points. F double dash x. F double dash x is minus 12x cube minus 24x cube minus 24x cube plus 12x square. 12x. Now f double dash 1 is equal to minus 24 plus 12. Minus 12 less than 0. F double dash minus 1. Minus 1 plus 24 minus 12. 12 greater than 0. So x is equal to 1 is the point of maxima and x is equal to minus 1 is the point of minima. And therefore, the fourth option, x equal to 1 is the point of maxima and minus 1 is the point of minima. That is also correct. The first one is x is equal to 1 is the point of minima and x equal to minus 1 is the point of maximum. That is wrong. So the first option is the answer. Now, the next problem. It is a problem in the section 2. The section 2 is an integer type. In this section, the answer can be either of a two-digit number or a number having decimal part also, but the decimals must be adjusted only up to two decimals. So here in the problem, if the mean and variance of eight numbers 3, 7, 9, 12, 13, 20, x, y So these are the observations given. These are the observations given. And the mean is given to be 10. X bar equal to mean equal to sum of the numbers by number of numbers. 3 plus 7 plus 9 plus 12 plus 13 plus 20 plus x plus y by 8 is equal to 10. I mean the sum is 64. X plus y equal to 80 minus 64, that is 16. You can call it in the first equation. Variance, this is a mean, of course, mean. Variance is equal to sigma square equal to sigma xi square by n minus x bar whole square. This is given to be 25. So x, this is a 9 plus 49 plus 81 plus 144 plus 169 plus 400 plus x square plus y square by 8 minus this is 100 is equal to 25. So this is 852. So x square plus y square equal to this is 125 into 8, 1000. 1000 minus 852, that is 148. This is the second one. Now here from the first and second equations, we can have x plus y whole square equal to x square plus y square plus 2xy. We are asked to find out the value of xy. X plus y is 16, that is 256 from the first equation. This is 148 plus 2xy. It implies xy equal to 256 minus 148. 108, 108 by 2 is 54. So the resultant is 54. Next problem. If the function f defined by, defined on minus 1 by 3 comma 1 by 3 open by fx is equal to 1 by x into log 1 plus 3x by 1 minus 2x by 1 minus 2x base e when x for x not equal to 0. For x not equal to 0, k for x is equal to 0 is a continuous at x equal to 0, then k is continuous at x equal to 0. Then k is. Now here, if it is said to be continuous in x equal to 0, so f of 0 must be equal to limit extends to 0 f of x. F of 0 is nothing but k. K equal to limit extends to 0 1 by x into log 1 plus 3x by 1 minus 2x base e. By direct substitution, this will become 1. This also will become 1. Log 1, 0. So it is approaching to 0 by 0. Now we'll write as limit extends to 0. Log m by n. Log m, log 1 plus 3x minus log 1 plus 2x by x. Now, if you substitute once again, it will become 0 by 0. Now it can be split into limit extends to 0 log 1 plus 3x by x minus limit extends to 0 log, this is 1 minus 2x, log 1 minus 2x by 1 minus 2x by x. Actually, limit extends to 0 log 1 plus x by x is equal to 1. Is equal to 1. So, by applying that formula here, you can say limit 3x tends to 0. Here it is 3 log 1 plus 3x by 3x. Because here 3x is there, here there must be 3. 3x minus limit, this is log 1 minus 2x by limit minus 2x tends to 0, here there must be minus 2x. So that is 2 here, this minus will come and here it will become plus. So here limit x tends to 0, log 1 plus x by x form. So this is 1 into 3. So 3 plus and it is k and this is 2 log 1 minus 2x by log 1 minus 2x by minus 2x as minus 2x tends to 0. This is 1. So this is 2. So the result is 5. So k is equal to 5. The next problem. Let x is equal to set of all n belongs to capital N, that is the natural numbers, 1 less than or equal to n less than or equal to 50. If a is equal to set of all n belongs to x such that n is a multiple of n is a multiple of 2. Now b is equal to set of all n belongs to x such that n is a multiple of 7. Now then the number of elements in the smallest subset of x containing both a and b. Here a is equal to multiples of 2, so that is, and n is a member of x, that means n is a natural number, should lie between 1 and 50, 2, 4, 6 and so on, this is a 50. So it implies n of a is equal to 25 and this is equal to set of all 7, 14 and so on, and this is 49. So n of b is equal to 7. A intersection b, set of all n belongs to x such that n is a multiple of 14, that is both 2 and 7, so 14. So this is equal to 14 and 28 and 42. So it implies n of A intersection B equal to 3. We are asked to find out the smallest subset of X containing both A as well as B. So all the elements of A should present and B also should. So we are asked to find out n of A union B. N of A union B equal to n of A plus n of B minus n of A intersection B. So this is 25 plus 7, 32 minus 3, 29. So the number of elements in the union A union B equal to 29. If the foot of the perpendicular drawn from 1, 0, 3 on a line passing through alpha 7 1 is 5/3, 7/3, 17/3, then alpha equal to. It is given that the foot of the perpendicular of P on this line is this point, say M. This is a perpendicular. Now the DRs of PM. DRs can be calculated by taking the differences. 5/3 - 1, 2/3, 7/3 - 0, 7/3, 17/3 - 3, 8/3. And the DRs of MQ, α - 5/3, 7 - 7/3, 7 - 7/3 means 14/3, 1 - 17/3, -14/3. Here, these two, PM is a perpendicular to QM. If PM is perpendicular to QM and DRs are A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, then if the lines are perpendicular, A1A2 plus B1B2 plus C1C2 equal 0. So 2 by 3 into alpha minus 5 by 3 plus 7 by 3 into 14 by 3 plus 8 by 3 into minus 14 by 3 is equal to 0. This is 2 by 3 into alpha minus 5 by 3. This is 7 by 3 into 14 by 3. This is 8 by 3 into minus 14 by 3. 1 by 3 into 14 by 3. This 3 gets cancelled 2, 7 times. And therefore alpha equal to 7 by 3 plus 5 by 3. 12 by 3. This is 4. Here, if A1, B1, C1, comma A2, B2, C2 are DRs of, direction ratios of two perpendicular lines, then A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 equal to 0. The second point, the DRs of a line joining AX1Y1 Z1, comma BX2Y2 Z2 are X2 minus X1, comma Y2 minus Y1, Z2 minus Z1. These two formulas are made use. Yeah. So these are the formulas. The next question. If the system of equations x plus y plus z equal to 6, x plus 2y plus 3z is equal to 10, 3x plus 2y plus lambda z is equal to mu has more than two solutions, then mu minus lambda square is. Now here I introduce a method. Here the equations are a1x plus b1y plus c1z is equal to d1, a2x plus b2y plus c2z is equal to d2, a3x plus b3y plus c3z is equal to d3 is a system of non-homogeneous equations. Now we'll consider its augmented matrix. Augmented matrix can be taken as A1, B1, C1, D1, A2, B2, C2, D2, A3, B3, C3, D3. By applying the row operations, it must be reduced to a different form. So it must be reduced on applying elementary row operations or row transformations. Row operations, reduce it to P1, P2, P3, P4, 0, P5, P6, P7, 0, 0, P8 and P9. This is called the echelon form of the matrix. This is called echelon form. Here in this context, if P8 not equal to 0, the system has a unique solution. Number 2, if P8 equal to 0, comma P9 not equal to 0, the system has no solution. If P8 is equal to 0, comma P9 is equal to 0, and either P5 not equal to 0 or P6 not equal to 0, then it has infinite number of solutions. Infinite number of solutions. So now we'll apply the echelon from here. First of all, we'll consider the augmented matrix. Augmented matrix. This is 1, 1, 1, 6, 1, 2, 3, 10, 3, 2, lambda, mu. R2 fx, R2 minus R1, R3 fx, R3 minus 3R. Now this is same as 1, 1, 1, 6, 1 minus 1, 0, 2 minus 1, 1, 3 minus 1, 2, 10 minus 6, 4, 3 minus 3, 0, 2 minus 3, 2 minus 3, minus 1, lambda minus 3, mu minus 18. Now, here, this must be equal to 0. R3 fx, R3 plus R2. Now, this is equal to 1, 1, 1, 6, 0, 1, 2, 4, 0. This is a 0. This is a lambda minus 1. This is mu minus 14. So what we require actually, mu minus lambda square. Now here, it is said that the equation has more than two solutions. That means, more than two solutions means, it can also be considered the infinite number of solutions. These two must be equal to zero. So here, for the system is said to have more than two solutions. That implies it has an infinite number of solutions. If that is the case, lambda minus 1 equals 0, mu minus 14 equals 0. Now lambda equal to 1 and mu equal to 14. We are asked to find out mu minus lambda square. 14 minus 1, 13 is the result.